神的福气。
Thank God for His grace to come here to the church to enjoy His blessings.
小弟现在奉主耶稣圣名，跟大家一起来查考。主啊，我向来等候你的救恩。
In the name of Jesus Christ, we're going to study together. Oh Lord, I have waited for your salvation.
我们请大家翻开《创世纪》四十九章。
Please turn to Genesis 49.
创世纪四十九章。
Genesis chapter 49.
第十八节。
Verse 18.
创世纪四十九章十八节。
Genesis 49 verse 18。
这里圣经说：“啊，主神啊，我向来等候你的救恩。”
Here it says, "I have waited for your salvation, O Lord."
啊，这是我们今天啊读经的进度，第四十九章。
This is our reading Bible reading progress on Genesis chapter 49.
啊，今天早上就用这一节经文做题目，跟大家来查考，我们当如何等候神的救恩。
So this morning, I want to use this verse that says, "How we can wait for our salvation."
我们真的等候神救恩的人会有什么样的表现
？And if we are truly waiting for God's salvation, then what will it look like?
啊，这句话啊是雅各在年老他要离世之前啊向他的儿子们所说的。
This was what Jacob had said when he became older and he had spoke to his sons.
啊，所以我们在读创世纪四十九章的时候，看到雅各。他一一为他的儿子们祝福。
In Genesis chapter 49, we know that Jacob was blessing his sons one by one.
那这当中啊，有一些啊，真的是祝福，但是有一些他看到的是患难。
Among these, some of these were blessings, but some of these he had noticed there would be trials.
那有一些啊，甚至也是这个做父亲的，他已经用他属灵的眼睛去看到。他这子孙的未来。
Or some because he could truly see with his spiritual eye the future of his sons.
啊，是因为出于神的感动。
And this was because he was moved by God.
啊，因为雅各他走完一生的时候，他特别说，这位神啊是牧养他、保护他一生的神。
Because after Jacob had gone through his entire life, he knew that God was the God who had shepherded him.
啊，他虽然看得到。以后子孙他们可能的发展
，Even though he could see what would happen to his children and descendants，
但是他却没有能力去改变他们的。
He had no ability to change them。
最后一定是只有神才有能力，也才有这个恩典，让这些孩子们改变。
Ultimately, only God could truly change these children。
所以我们看雅各他在祝福众儿子的这个当中，他突然说了这一句非常重要的话语。
And so as Jacob was blessing his sons, then he suddenly said this verse that was very important.
这句话是在他对但这个儿子所讲的话之后所说出来的。
This is what he said after he spoke to his son Dan.
因为第十六节就是有关于这个儿子但他的将来。
Verse 16, he was speaking about the future of Dan.
他说。第十六节，但必判断他的民，做以色列支派之一。
Verse 16, Dan shall judge his people as one of the tribes of Israel.
十七节，但必做道上的蛇，路中的虺，咬伤马蹄，使骑马的坠落于后。
17, Dan shall be a serpent by the way, a viper by the path, that bites the horse's heel so that its rider shall fall backward.
十八节，主啊，我向来等候你的救恩。
18, I have waited for your salvation, O Lord.
所以，这其实看到。雅各他内心的盼望。
So this is saying the hope of Jacob's heart.
他知道他这个儿子但他将来会做出一些事实上是不应该做的事情。
He knew that his son Dan will do some things that he should not do.
他成为一种很暴力、很奸诈的人。
He has become someone who is violent and very cunning.
可是。雅各作为父亲的，他却无力改变，他只能够真的仰望主神的救恩。
As a father, Jacob could not change anything, but he can only look up to Lord's salvation.
在雅各的对儿子的祝福里面，我们看到了他真的看到神他即将来的拯救。
And as he was blessing his son, he could see that God will provide his salvation.
那我们在读这段历史的时候
，When we are studying this history.
我们其实不是只是要增加这些圣经上的知识而已。
We're not just trying to gain the knowledge in our biblical knowledge.
我们事实上是要明白神借着救恩所要告诉我们的 这圣经告诉我们的救恩它的意义在哪里。
We need to understand what is the meaning that God is trying to tell us about His salvation.
什么叫做真的等候神的救恩？
What does it mean to truly wait for His salvation?
今天我们来到教会，我们所领受的这个救恩对我们的意义在哪里？
And today when we come to this church, the salvation we have received, what is the meaning?
我们许多人都是在教会长大的第二代或第三代，甚至更久的这个信徒的子孙。
Many of us have grown up in the church since we were young, or we are second, third, or maybe even fourth generations.
那我们对我们所敬拜这个神，我们到底有多少认识
？To this God whom we worship, how much do we truly know Him?
我们是不是会真的感谢我们的祖先来到基督面前成为主的门徒，让我们很自然地承受了这个救恩呢？
Are we truly thankful for our ancestors that they were able to come to believe and that we have received the salvation as well?
我们是否真的将原本我父亲的神把它转换成我自己的神呢？
Have we truly transformed that God that was my father's God to my own true God?
那也能够明白说这个神他是带领我一生的神。
And can we understand that this is a God who will guide our entire life?
最后我们也能够存着一个非常坚定的信心，仰望他所赐给我们的永生，天国的产业。
So that at the end we can truly also have hope in heaven in that heavenly inheritance.
所以我们虽然住在地上，但是我们的盼望却不是只是在地面上的。
Even though we live in this world, our hope is not in this world.
我们有一个更高的、更属灵的、永存的盼望。
We have a higher and spiritual eternal hope.
那这个就是在创世纪里面所告诉我们的要等候神的救恩。
This is what Genesis is telling us that we need to wait for God's salvation.
所以我们要从三方面来看我们怎么样等候神的救恩。
So we're going to look at it from three aspects how we can wait for God's salvation.
我们要从神拣选他的选民特别是有关于雅各的一生来看，我们本来是不配的人，但是却得到这个救恩。
And the first is that God has chosen His people, has chosen Jacob. So we need to see from especially from Jacob's life.
也就是说，我们本来并不是什么特别的人物，可以得到神的恩典的。
So originally we were no one special that we deserve this grace.
我们要先对神的拣选有所领会。
We need to first have an understanding of being chosen.
我们才会内心生出感谢。
So that we will have thanksgiving.
那我们也才看到这个救恩，神的恩典有多宝贵。
Then we can see how precious the salvation is.
第二个，我们要看当神拣选我们之后。
The second we're going to see is when God has chosen us.
我们成为神的选民。
We have become God's chosen people.
我们也会一样遭遇到许多很不如意的事情。
And in the same way, we will face many things that do not go well.
甚至我们的遭遇可能比不信的人还悲惨。
We may even go through more than people who do not believe.
但是如果我们真的是等候神的救恩的。
But if we are truly waiting for God's salvation.
我们最后会看到神的意思原是好的。
We will see that God's intention was good.
虽然表面上看起来好像是很不幸的事情。
Even though something truly seems very bad.
但是在神的安排跟他的祝福底下，我们最后一定会明白，原来神他对我们是这么样的慈爱。他是这样子引导我们的一生的。
But under God's arrangement, His will, His blessings, and we can see that God has truly been guiding our entire life.
那第三个，我们要从雅各、约瑟他们的人生结束的时候，他们所说的话看到，我们需要有天上永存的盼望。
And the third is that from Jacob and Joseph near the end of their life, then we can see their hope.
真的有救恩的人是天上有盼望的人。
People who truly have salvation are people who have a hope in heaven.
不是只是眼睛看到地面上这些花花绿绿的世界。
They do not only see the bright colors of this world.
所以我们要从圣经里面好好想一想，今天我们是何等有福的人。
So from the Bible, we need to see how blessed we are.
我们是何等的有目标的人。
And we should have a goal.
我们是怎么样一个有盼望的人。
And how we can have a hope.
所以我们的生命可以跟这个世界不一样。
So that our life can be different from this world.
我们首先来看创世纪三十二章。
Let's first look at Genesis 32.
创世纪三十二章。
Genesis 32.
三十二章，我们请看第九节。
Verse 9.
创世纪三十二章第九节。
Genesis 32 verse 9.
雅各说：“主神，我祖先亚伯拉罕的神，我父亲以撒的神啊，你曾对我说，回你本地本族去，我要厚待你。”
Verse 9, then Jacob said, O God of my father Abraham and God of my father Isaac, the Lord who said to me, return to your country and to your family, and I will deal well with you.
第十节，你向仆人所施的一切慈爱和诚实，我一点也不配得。我先前只拿着我的杖过这约旦河，如今我却成了两队了。
10. I am not worthy of the least of all the mercies and of all the truth which you have shown your servant, for I crossed over this Jordan with my staff, and now I have become two companies.
11节，求你救我脱离我哥哥以扫的手，因为我怕他来杀我，连妻子带儿女一同杀了。
11. Deliver me, I pray, from the hand of my brother, from the hand of Esau, for I fear him, lest he come and attack me and the mother with the children.
12节，你曾说，我必定厚待你，使你的后裔如同海边的沙，多得不可胜数。
12. For you said, I will surely treat you well and make your descendants as the sand of the sea, which cannot be numbered for multitude.
这是雅各，他到了他的舅舅家拉班，去成家立业20年之后，他回到要回到他的故乡的路上，他向神所做了一次祷告。
After Jacob had gone to his uncle Laban's house after 20 years, this was the prayer that he had to God.
他在年其实他是年纪不小了，他一个人离开他的父家，要到舅舅家去要娶妻，要成立家庭。
He was becoming older and alone. He had gone to his uncle'sHouse and he had married his daughter and then was starting a family.
所以他说，我先前只是拿一根杖过这个约旦河。
This is why before he said that he crossed the Jordan with his staff.
所以他一个人单独离家。
And so alone he left his home.
但是二十年之后，他却成了两大队的人马，带了许多的财物要回来了。
But 20 years later he had two companies and he had many possessions.
这个时候，雅各已经有11个儿子，有一个女儿。
By this time, Jacob had 11 sons and one daughter.
他本来是要娶一个妻子，结果这个最后因着许多的许多的错误呢，他成了有两个妻子，有两个妾。
Originally, Jacob was only going to marry one wife, but because of many different mistakes that he made, he had actually.Two main wives and also two concubines.
那这也是神更高的旨意，是当时候雅各他不明白的。
And God had actually a more important will that Jacob did not understand at the time.
但是等到他的时间应该回家的时候，神就告诉他你离开你舅舅的家，回到你父亲那里去了。
So when it was time, then God had told Jacob that he could leave his uncle's house and could go back to his home.
所以第九节就是雅各他跟神祷告说，你曾经告诉我要回到本地本族去，我要厚待你，这是神在之前向 雅各所讲的话。
In verse 9, when Jacob was speaking to God, this was because God had spoken to him before.
这是31章的第八节神向他所下的命令。
This was in chapter 31 and the command that God had given to Jacob.
那当时候你看第十节，雅各就说：“你向仆人所施的这一切的慈爱、诚实，我一点也不配得。”
And in verse 10, Jacob has said, "I am not worthy of the least of all the mercies and of all the truth which you have shown."
也就是说，雅各他很感谢神对他一切的赏赐。
And so Jacob was very thankful to everything God gave him.
他本来是不配得了。
He was not worthy.
因为他觉得他在这一段过程当中。其实如果不是神的恩典，他可能什么都没有的。
Because he felt that throughout this whole process, if it was not for the grace of God, then he would have nothing.
他相信这一切都是神额外的，是真的是恩典的赏赐，没有计算他，没有去算说你是不是能够有那个能力得到这些东西的。
He believed that all of these blessings and grace were given in addition, but he was not worthy of it at all.
所以雅各他存了一个非常感谢的心来领受神给他这些祝福。
And so Jacob had a very thankful heart for all these blessings from God.
因为神给他慈爱诚实，神是信实的，神对他应许一一的实现了。
Because God was faithful and all his promises were starting to come true.
他当有困难的时候，神就为他出面解决。
When he had a challenge, then God would help him and resolve it.
他被欺负的时候，神为他伸冤。
When he was attacked, then God would stand up for him.
所以也就是说，其实雅各他的 他的一生当中，他大小的事情都是靠着神得到解决的了。
And so throughout his entire life, anything that was bad that happened, God could still help him solve them.
所以雅各他觉得说他本来是不配，但是他竟然拥有这么多。
And so Jacob felt that he was not worthy, yet he had so much.
这是我们今天对有关于神的救恩一定要先有的这种心理了解。
This is the first understanding that we should have in order to understand his salvation.
其实我们看创世纪里面，我们看到神他出于他绝对的主权所做的拣选。
If we look at Genesis, then God had used His authority to choose people.
神从万民当中去选了亚伯拉罕。
God out of all the multitudes had chosen Abraham.
并不是说亚伯拉罕他最聪明，他最富有，还是他最良善。
Not because Abraham was the wealthiest or the smartest or the kindest.
并不是亚伯拉罕他说他有什么真的很好的特质，说配得神给他这些祝福。
Not because Abraham had any quality that was worthy for these blessings.
没有，事实上是因为神。他主动的拣选。
It was because God Himself had chosen him.
圣经说神要拣选谁就拣选谁。
And the Bible has said, whoever God wants, then He can choose.
今天我们被拣选的人一定要非常的感谢。
And today, for those of us who have been chosen, we must be thankful.
你看神拣选亚伯拉罕之后，神就跟他显现。
After God had chosen Abraham, then He revealed Himself.
告诉他的人生应该怎么走。
And told him how he could walk on in his life.
而且住在哪里才能够持守住这个信仰。
And where he had to live in order to hold on to his faith.
亚伯拉罕就一一的听神的指示，就这样生活，就这样迁移。
And one by one, Abraham would move wherever God told him to.
你看，渐渐的神，亚伯拉罕跟神的关系就建立起来了。
And gradually, Abraham had built a relationship with God.
然后他把这个信仰就一代一代的传下来了。
And he had passed on this faith throughout generations.
等到雅各的时候，已经是第三代了。
By the time of Jacob, then this was the third generation.
那个时候的雅各，其实他还不是很一开始还不是很认识神。
Jacob at the time at the beginning did not truly know God.
因为他虽然在父亲的家里。
Because even though he was in his father's house,
但是毕竟这个神还是父亲的神。
This God was the father, or the God his father.
他一开始要离家的时候，他在野地里面。
So at the beginning, when he was leaving his home in the wilderness,
他做了一个梦。
He had a dream.
在梦中，神跟他讲话。
And in the dream, God has spoken to him.
他醒过来的时候，他才恍然大悟。
When he awoke, then he realized.
我们看第二十八章。
Chapter 28.
第二十八章。
Chapter 28,
第十三节
verse 13,
神在梯子以上对他说：“我是主神，你祖先亚伯拉罕的神，也是以撒的神。”
13, and behold, the Lord stood above it and said, "I am the Lord God of Abraham, your father, and the God of Isaac."
这是神跟他的介绍。
This is how God introduced himself.
我是你祖先，你祖父亚伯拉罕的神，也是你父亲以撒的神。
I am the Lord God of Abraham, your father, and the God of Isaac.
那时候神跟他说：“我要跟你同在。”
At the time, God told him, "I will be with you."
你不论往哪里去，我都要。把你保佑你，领你归回这个地方。
And wherever you go, then I will protect you.
我总不离弃你，直到我成全的向你所应许的。
For I will not leave you until I have done what I have spoken to you.
第十六节。
16.
雅各睡醒了，他说：“神真在这里，我竟不知道。”
Then Jacob awoke from sleep and said, "Surely the Lord is in this place and did not know it."
这个地方何等可畏！这不是别的，乃是神的殿，天的门。
17, he was afraid and said, "How awesome is this place? There, this is none other than the house of God."
那这个时候，雅各他当时候还不知道说神事实上是一路跟着他的。
At this time, Jacob did not know that God had been with him this whole journey.
神跟他一起到野地里面呢。
God had gone with him to the wilderness.
神现在要跟他一起到他的舅舅家拉班去，
and God,
拉班的家去了。
God will go with him to go to the house of Laban.
他现在他说雅各他睡醒，他说哇，这个地方何等可畏，神就在这里。
And so when he woke up, then Jacob said, "This place is so very awesome, and God is here."
那时候雅各他对神的认识其实是也是很肤浅的。
The understanding that Jacob had at the time was very on the surface.
他只是关心他要有一个家庭，他需要能够地上有生活，有好的生活。
He had concern that he needed to have a family and have a good life.
所以第二十节。
Verse 20.
你看他向神许愿说：“神若与我同在，在我所行的路上保佑我，又给我食物吃，衣服穿，使我平平安安的回到我父亲的家，我就必以主为我的神。”
Then Jacob made a vow, saying, "If God will be with me and keep me in this way that I am going, and give me bread to eat and clothing to put on."
21节。
21, so that I can come back to my father's house in peace, then the Lord shall be my God.
第二十二节说：“我所立为柱子的石头必做神的殿。”凡你所赐给我的，我必将十分之一献给你。
22. And the stone which I have set as a pillar shall be God's house, and of all that you give me, I will surely give a tenth to you.
你看那个时候，这个时候的雅各，他其实很在意的是，他又有食物吃，有衣服穿，在这个路上得到平安而已啊。
Jacob at this time had only concerns that he needed to have food to eat and clothing to wear.
但是然后之后我就以主为我的神。
And with this, then he would have God be his God.
也就是说，他要先看到神给他的祝福啊，让他生活衣食无缺的时候，哎，他才会认为说，哎，这个才是真正我的神。
Which means that at the time he needed to make sure that he was able to be fed and be clothed by God, then he would have God be his God.
那这个也说明，你看，本来这个神是他祖先、祖父的神、父亲的神。
So originally, this is the God of his grandfather and his father.
那个时候他还没有体验。
At the time, he did not have an experience yet.
但是他现在要离家，要出远门。
But now he is going to leave his home and to go afar.
他现在许愿跟神说，如果他在生活上能够感受到是神赐福给他，让他有食物吃，有衣服穿，有平安。那时候这个神就是我的神了。
And so he made a vow that if during his whole journey, then God had given him food and clothing and peace, then he would have God be his God.
这是一个在说明我们今天信仰要怎么样。要怎么样能够真的建立起来，就是要有真的有体验。
This is to say, if we really want to establish our faith, then we need to have an experience.
这个体验就是我们生活上实际的体验的。
This experience is the direct experience in our life.
哦，所以通常我们在小的时候，我们还没有负担一个家庭，我们通常因为不管发生什么事情，总是有父母亲顶着。
So when we are younger and we don't have a family yet, many times whatever happens, we still have parents who can help us.
但是当我们一个人他成立了家庭，他真的有负担责任以后。他就在信仰上若有追求，一定会有体验。这个时候信仰就能建立。
But when a person has become older and has established their own family and something has happened, then this would, and God helps them, then they would truly have an experience in their faith.
所以我们通常信仰的建立都要真的有生活上的实际体验里面去而来的。
So if we really want to establish our faith, then we have to have experiences.
所以雅各，你看他最后经过二十年之后。这个神成为他的神了。
And so after 20 years, then Jacob had this God that became his God.
因为他觉得他本来是不配的。
Because he felt that he did not deserve this.
他就非常的感谢。
And so he was very thankful.
他也抓住了神给他的应许。
And he held on to the promise that God gave him.
所以今天我们在教会所领受这个救恩。
And so today in church when we have received the salvation.
其实我们本来也是不配得的。
We originally did not deserve this either.
我们本来也不认识神。
We did not know God.
我们更不知道什么谁是耶稣。
We did not know who Jesus was.
我们不知道耶稣为我们所做的事情是何等的伟大的一个牺牲。
We did not know how great Jesus' sacrifice was.
但是主的恩典就这样临到我们。
But the grace of Lord Jesus has come to us.
所以我们便能在这个恩典上有份了。
So that we have part in this grace.
所以以弗所书第二章说。
And so in Ephesians chapter 2 it says,
以弗所书第二章,
Ephesians chapter 2,
第二节,
verse
2. 第二章第二节说, 那时你们在其中行事为人, 随从今世的风俗, 顺从空中掌权者的首领, 就是现今在悖逆之子心中运行的邪灵。
Verse 2, in which you once walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit who now works in the sons of disobedience.
第三节。我们从前也都在他们中间晃动肉体的事意，随从肉体和心中所喜好的去行，本为可弄之子，和别人一样。
Through among whom also we all once conducted ourselves in the lusts of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature children of wrath, just as the others.
第四节，然而神既有丰富的怜悯，因为他爱我们的大爱，当我们死在过犯中的时候，他便叫我们与基督一同活过来。啊，你们得救是本乎恩。
For, but God, who is rich in mercy because of his great love with which he loved us, five, even when we were dead in trespasses, made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved.
第六节，他又叫我们在我们与基督耶稣一同复活，一同坐在天上，要将他极丰富的恩典，就是他在基督耶稣里向我们所施的恩慈，显明给后来的世代看。
Six, and raised us up together and made us sit together in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus. 7. That in the ages to come he might show the exceeding riches of his grace and his kindness toward us in Christ Jesus.
现在这一段圣经在提醒我们啊，我们啊本来是一个不配得恩的人。
So the passage is telling us that originally we were not worthy.
我们本来是也是随着肉体和心中所喜好的去行，是可怒之子啊，跟世人都一样的。
We were following the flesh or following the prince of the power of the air and just like the world.
那现在主耶稣的恩典临到我们。
But now the Lord Jesus' grace has come upon us.
这个恩典就是我们没有付出什么，我们 不配得，但是竟然得到，这才叫恩典。
This grace is that we did not do anything and we were not worthy, but we have received this.
我们现在因着耶稣的救赎，可以离开罪恶，可以跟他一同复活，坐在天上。
And because of Lord Jesus' salvation, then we are able to resurrect and live, abide with Him in heaven.
我们要将那极丰富的恩典显明给后来的世代看。
And show in the ages to come the exceeding riches of His grace.
那这个也就是说，今天我们领受救恩之后有一个责任。
This is to say that today, when we have received this grace, we have a responsibility.
我们的如果能够真的感谢主耶稣的救赎。
If we can truly be thankful of this salvation from
Jesus,
if we have truly resurrected with Lord Jesus and are living in heaven,
我们生活一定会改变,
then our life would surely change.
因为我们的目标不是只是在这个地面上而已,
because our goal is not just to live in this world.
我们知道我们, 被拣选之后所赋予的责任,
we know that after we have been chosen, our responsibility,
要让这个神真的活在我们的生命里,
that God should truly live in our life,
带领我们的一生。
And guide our life.
所以我们的表现跟这个世人是可怒之子的是不一样的。
So that whatever we do, that is different than these people of the world.
所以雅各，你看他深深了解他自己本来是不配的人。
Jacob truly understood that he was someone who did not deserve this.
可是神现在一路引领他。
But now God has guided his life.
祝福他又保护他。
And blessed him and protected him.
你看不但给他家庭儿女，又许多的财富。
Not only did he have many children, but he had much wealth.
遇到困难的时候，神出手拯救他。
When there is difficulty, then God would help him.
所以雅各他真的到最后人生要结束的时候，他很满足。
And so at the end, when his life was about to end, he was very satisfied.
所以他说，这个神是一生牧养我的神。
And so he said that this is a God who has shepherded my entire life.
这个神正为变成他的神。
And this God became his God.
创世纪48章。
Genesis 48.
创世纪四十八章
，Genesis 48，
四十八章的第十五节
，48 verse 15，
这是雅各他对他所得到恩典，他所敬拜这位神最后他的描述。
This is one of the last descriptions when Jacob was blessing his sons.
第十五节，他给约瑟祝福说：“愿我主亚伯拉罕和我父亲以撒所侍奉的神，就是一生牧养我直到今日的神。”救赎我脱离一切患难的那使者，祝福赐福给这两个童子。
15, and he blessed Joseph and said, God, before whom my fathers Abraham and Isaac walked, the God who has fed me all my life long to this day, 16, the angel who has redeemed me from all evil, bless the lads.
你看他这里，雅各已经将这个父亲、祖父、父亲的神，现在他更深刻的了解，这是牧养我一生。的神是脱离我救一切患难的使者了。
He knew that this was the God who is a God of his father and grandfather, but also the God who has fed him all his life long to this day, and the angel who has redeemed him from all evil.
那其实我们看雅各的一生，我们发现他遭遇许多的患难，很多的挫折。
And if we look at Jacob's entire life, we know that he had faced many challenges.
他回到迦南地之后
，After he returned to Canaan,
他其实先经历了他的女儿被世间人玷污的这个事情。
He had to face when his daughter was abused by the people.
Defiled. 他的女儿是被世间人玷污的。
And it was the people of Shechem who had defiled her.
那因为这个事件，所以让他的两个儿子西缅跟利未呢？用诡计去屠杀了当时的世间城的男丁。
And because his daughter was defiled, and his two sons had violently attacked the people of Shechem.
那这个就是在第三十四章所记载的。
This is recorded in chapter 34.
那当时候其实你看雅各他这个家庭遭遇很大的挑战。
And during this time, the household of Jacob had encountered a great challenge.
那事实上是因为雅各他没有完全遵守神所吩咐他的。
This was actually because Jacob did not completely obey what God had told him.
他本来是应该从巴旦亚兰回来，要直接到伯特利去。
When he had, he should have immediately gone to Bethel.
但是他竟然在苏哥，在事件停留了，耽搁了。
Actually stopped in Shechem and was held there for a bit.
在这个地方，他真的就一些患难出现。
And in this place was where these things had happened.
所以当 这个屠杀的事件出现之后，他就要赶紧逃离那个地方。
And so, they had to immediately leave the place.
所以他说我们要赶快离开，不然我们就全家灭绝了。
And he had to leave immediately, otherwise, their entire family would have been killed.
这个时候第三十五章就是神出手拯救他。
And then chapter 35 was when God Himself had helped him.
神要雅各起来到伯特利去。
God wanted Jacob to get up and go to Bethel.
在那个地方筑坛，在那里要住在那里。
And build an altar and live there.
神就在那个地方为他再一次的显向他显现，然后来应许他要带领他的路。
And there God appeared to him and guided him.
那我们看到之后，你看他的妻子，所爱的妻子拉结生了最后的儿子之后，就是难产死了。
And we know that there, then Rebecca had a last child, and then she died in childbirth.
所以雅各，你看他人生接下来还是遇到许许多多很悲惨的事情。
And then the rest of his life, Jacob had also faced many sad things.
在这个人生的旅程当中，其实我们在世上所遭遇的跟一般的世人并没有两样。
And the journey of life, many things that we encounter are very similar to people in the world.
那雅各，你看他这是。后来就生了就有十二个儿子了。
And later on, Jacob had 12 sons.
这十二个儿子，他其实之间呢，真的很良善的这样子很敬畏神的，也没有几个。
And but among the 12 sons, actually, those who were very kind or very fearing God, there were actually very few.
这些儿子们呢，常常做一些让父亲觉得很生气、不应该是的事情。
Many of these sons would often do things that their father would not be pleased in.
那在这个众多儿子里面这个第十一个儿子约瑟呢，最特别得到他的疼爱。
And among all of these sons, then the 11th son Joseph, then he was the one who was loved.
所以第三十七章我们就看到约瑟他出现了。
And in chapter 37, we know that Joseph appeared.
这个约瑟，你看他特别而这个父亲呢，特别给他做了一件很漂亮的彩衣。
And his father has specially made a very beautiful coat for him.
那是因为也是因为这个儿子他很正直，很圣洁。
And it was because this son was very righteous and very holy.
所以当他知道哥哥们一些恶行、不好的行为的时候，他会向父亲报告。
So when he heard of things about his brothers, then he would report to his father.
所以因为雅各在年老的时候生了这个儿子。
And because when Jacob was older, he had this son.
也是因为约瑟的母亲拉结是雅各特别疼、特别喜爱的一个妻子。
And because Joseph's mother Rachel was the one whom Jacob loved.
你看雅各呢，他对约瑟特别好，特别爱他。
Jacob especially loved Joseph.
但是因为他的爱因为他的一些他的这个他的好行为那也带来了家庭兄弟之间。嫉妒他，然后甚至仇恨他的结果。
But because of this love and what he has shown, then there were many tension, much tension between the brothers and Joseph.
所以最后约瑟被他的哥哥们把他出卖了。
So that at the end, Joseph was sold by his brothers.
那这个做父亲的，他得到消息是这个儿子已经被野兽把他撕裂了。
And when Jacob had heard the news, he had heard that Joseph was eaten by the wild beast.
所以雅各在年老的时候，他以为他的儿子已经死了，他为他哀哭多日。
And so when Jacob was older, then he thought that his son was dead and had cried for him many days.
他的儿子所做的这些出卖兄弟的事情，他们不敢跟他父亲说的。
And when even though his sons were the ones that sold him to slavery, but they did not dare to tell their father.
所以雅各一直被蒙在鼓里。
And so Jacob did not know this whole time.
他一直觉得说他失去了一个所爱的儿子。
This entire time he thought that he had lost a son whom he loved.
所以他这个事情对雅各来说是一个很大的打击。
And so this incident was something that was very hurtful to Jacob.
在他年老的时候，他多次的提到了他失去的这个所爱的儿子这个惨痛的经历。
When he became older, many times he recalled about when he lost his son.
所以他当时候一直觉得说，他这一生有遗憾。
And so he kept thinking that in his life there was this regret.
因为对雅各来说
，Because for Jacob,
他本来可以不让这个儿子遇到这个意外的。
Originally, he could have stopped this from happening to his son.
因为第三十七章
，in chapter 37,
雅各出于他对儿子，他对这个其他这个儿子的关爱，他特别派了这个小儿子，这个约瑟要去看望他的这些另外十个儿子们。
because Joseph had loved his, Jacob has loved his other sons, and so he has sent Joseph to go see his brothers.
他不让这个约瑟跟着这个哥哥们去牧羊，就是为了怕他遇到意外啊。
He did not let Joseph go to feed this flock with the brothers because he was afraid something would happen to him.
但是也就是因为这个关心，所以他把这个约瑟派出去要看望，要得到消息回来报告。
But then it was because Joseph had not gone with them, and so Jacob had sent Joseph to go see his brothers.
但是最后，他的兄弟们、啊、把这个弟弟啊，把他出卖，把他真的对他做了一些很恶毒的事情。
But then his brothers had gone to sell him to slavery and done something very wicked.
所以三十三节是三十七章三十三节，约雅各说、啊：“我的儿子被恶兽吃了，被撕碎了。”
And so in verse 33, Jacob recognized that and said, "It is my son's tunic; a wild beast has devoured him."
所以你看雅各呢，他现在本来可以避免的这个悲伤的事情，竟然发生了。
And so Jacob could have prevented this tragedy from happening.
这也是本来他一直想要避免的，就是怕他的兄弟这些十个儿子们去伤害这个他们所爱的弟，他所爱的弟弟。
This is what he had wanted to prevent. He wanted to prevent his 10 sons to, from attacking his 11th one.
但是哪里知道，你看，他人生总是有一些意料之外的事情发生了。
Yet there are many things in life that are beyond our expectations.
但是这当中其实有神更美好的旨意，是雅各不知道的。
But among this, even though God had a better plan, Jacob did not know.
所以你看这样子一消失，雅各啊，在二十二年之后啊，他才了解发生什么事情。
And so it was not until 22 years later that Jacob realized what had happened.
因为约瑟被卖到埃及去之后，你看神就引导他的脚步，最后他成为埃及的宰相。
Because after Joseph was sold to Egypt, then he after 20 years and God had allowed him to become the prime minister of Egypt.
那约瑟成了他们在这个饥荒当中的拯救了。
And Joseph had become the one who could save them from the famine.
这是神极美妙的安排。
This was a very beautiful arrangement from God.
是一般世人所看不到的。
This is something that people could not see.
雅各他当然不知道他儿子实际上是活着。
Jacob did not know that his son was alive.
他的这约瑟这个兄弟们，他们也没有想到他们所嫉妒所仇恨的这个儿子这个弟弟现在竟然就是掌权的宰相。
And Joseph's brothers could not have realized the brother that they had despised had become the prime minister.
当他们发现的时候他们非常害怕。
And when they discovered this, they were very afraid.
啊，所以当圣经记录约瑟跟他的哥哥们相认的时候，
And when the Bible recorded when Joseph had reconnected with his brothers.
第四十五章
45Chapter 45.
我们看第三节。
Verse 3.
约瑟对他的兄弟们说：“我是约瑟，我的父亲还在吗？”他弟兄不能回答，因为在他面前都惊慌了。
Verse 3. Then Joseph said to his brothers, "I am Joseph. Does my father still live?" But his brothers could not answer him, for they were dismayed in his presence.
那这个时候表示这些哥哥们他们真的不敢相信。
And so the brothers could not believe this.
他们所嫉妒的这个弟弟，现在竟然就是宰相。
The brother they were jealous of had now become the prime minister.
他们想起他们对这个弟弟所做的事情。
When they thought about all the things that they had done to their brother.
他们一直很自责，他们知道他们的错误。
And they had rebuked themselves, and they knew that they were wrong.
但是他们没有办法改变呢、啊。
But they could not change it.
这个事情就已经发生，就是摆在眼前了。
Because this had already happened.
这个时候，约瑟对他的弟兄们说。
And at this time, Joseph is his brother.
第四节，你们近前来。
Verse 4, please come near to me.
他们就近前来。他说：“我就是你们的兄弟约瑟，就是你们所卖到埃及的。”
So they came near, and then he said, "I am Joseph, your brother, whom you sold into Egypt."
第五节，现在不要因为把我卖到这里就自忧自恨，这是神差我在你们以先来，为要保全生命的。
Verse 5, but now do not therefore be grieved or angry with yourselves because you sold me here, for God sent me before you to preserve life.
第六节，现在这个地饥荒已经两年，还有五年不能耕种，不能收成。
6, for these 2 years of famine has been in the land, and there are still 5 years in which there will be neither plowing nor harvesting.
第七节，神差我在你们以先来，为要给你们存留余种在世上，又要大施拯救，保全你们的生命。
7, and God sent me before you to preserve a posterity for you in the earth and to save your lives by a great deliverance.
第八节，这样看来，差我到这里来的不是你们，乃是神。
8, for, so now it was not you who sent me here, but God.
那这个就是约瑟，他后来他明白神的旨意了。
And so later on, Joseph understood the will of God.
他知道哦，原来是神啊，在事情还没有发生以前，就先派他到埃及来准备啊，要来施行拯救，保全生命。
And so he realized that it was not his brothers, but actually his God who had this will for him to save the lives of his brothers.
所以什么是救恩？
So what is salvation?
救恩就是我们人想不到的。
Salvation is something we cannot imagine.
是在人看来本来是一些很不幸的事情，但其实有神更美好的旨意。
That in the eyes of man, it may seem like something that is very horrible, but in God, there is actually a very beautiful will.
约瑟一直约安慰他的哥哥们说，是神派我在你们以前来的。
Joseph kept comforting his brothers that it was God who had actually sent me here.
你们现在不要因为把我卖来这个看起来很不应该的事情而自由自恨，这是约瑟出于爱心的安慰。
And this was very comforting that Joseph had said when he wanted his brothers to not grieve or be angry with themselves.
最后在创世纪第五十章。
At the end in Genesis 50.
我们请看创世纪五十章。
Genesis chapter 50.
第十七节。
Verse 17.
多年之后，约瑟一样跟他哥哥们讲同样的话。
Many years later, Joseph said the same things to his brother. 啊，
我们直接看第十十九节就好。
Verse 19.
约瑟对他们说：“不要害怕，我岂能代替神呢？”二十节。
20.
从前你们的意思原是要害我，但神的意思原是好的，要保全许多人的性命，成就今日的光景。
19. Joseph said to them, "Do not be afraid, for am I in the place of God? 20. But as for you, you meant evil against me, but God meant it for good, in order to bring it about as it is this day, to save many people alive."
21. 节。现在你们不要害怕，我必养活你们和你们的妇人孩子。于是约瑟用亲爱的话安慰他们。
Now therefore, do not be afraid. I will provide for you and your little ones. And he comforted them and spoke kindly to them.
约瑟说，神的意思原是好的。
Joseph has said that the will of God is good.
但虽然你们的意思是要害我。
Even though you meant evil against me.
但是神，他就是有事先这样安排，要保全许多人的生命。
God had decided this beforehand that they would save many people.
所以神的救恩就是在人看来是一个很不幸的遭遇，但其实神他竟然就是用这个方式来施行拯救。
And so God's salvation is that in the eyes of man, it seemed like it was a very bad situation, but God meant to save.
所以救恩让我们人对患难有不一样的看法。
And so salvation means that we have a different perspective on tribulation.
今天我们信主之后，我们在人生可能人生当中会遭遇一些，也许我们不想遭遇的事情。
After we believe in the Lord, perhaps we will still face things that we don't want to face.
我们如果真的明白，这位神是带领我们一生的神。
If we truly understand that this is a God who will guide our life.
就像约瑟跟雅各一样，他们都明白他的一生都是神在引导的。
Just like Joseph and Jacob, they understood that their entire life was guided by God.
其实我们如果仔细想想，约瑟他到埃及去的生活，他真的遭遇的，我们现在一般人所没办法遭遇的。
And we can see that what Joseph had encountered when he was in Egypt were many things that we would not even face.
他从在家里面父亲所爱的儿子。
From being the beloved son in his father's house.
到最后他你看他被出卖成为奴隶。
He was sold and became a slave.
跑到埃及去真的是当奴隶的。
And had gone to Egypt to become a slave.
那不但这样，最后变成罪人被关起来。
Not only this, but he was imprisoned.
但是一夜之间，神让他成为埃及宰相。
But overnight, then God allowed him to become the prime minister.
他这个经历，你看，真的是非常的曲折，非常的很难承受的。
There are many ups and downs, and it was very difficult to experience this.
但是神就是有这样的安排啊。
But God had this arrangement.
要让后面的人可以看到，神的这个计划。远超过我们所能够想象的。
That people to come can see that what God has arranged is surpasses our understanding.
神的意思原是好的。
And God's what had God meant was good.
所以圣经说神的意念高过人的意念。
And so we know that God's thoughts surpass.
今天有时候我们会遇到患难挫折。
Sometimes today we will face tribulations.
但是我们不要灰心，不要害怕。
But we should not lose heart or be afraid.
我们看以赛亚书五十五章。
Let's look at Isaiah 55.
以赛亚书五十五章。
Isaiah 55.
第八节。
Verse 8.
以赛亚书五十五章第八节。
Isaiah 55 verse 8.
主说：“我的意念非同你们的意念，我的道路非同你们的道路。”
Verse 8. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways.
第九节。
Verse 9.
天怎样高过地，照样我的道路高过你们的道路，我的意念高过你们的意念。
For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, my thoughts than your thoughts.
那所以你看神他美好的安排，让看起来好像是很不幸的事情，最后竟然成就神美好的旨意。 让人想不到的。
So with God's beautiful arrangement, then even though something seemed very bad at first, but actually God had meant it for a better will.
你看神准备了约瑟到埃及去以后。
After God had arranged Joseph to Egypt,
他不但拯救了雅各的全家。
Not only did he save the entire household.
他也拯救了当时埃及的人呢。
He also saved the Egyptians.
不但埃及人当中周围许多国家的百姓。
Not only Egypt, but many of the peoples in the surrounding area.
在那个饥荒没有食物的年代，他们只要愿意到埃及来，他们都可以得到食物。
During that famine, if they were willing and they went to Egypt, then they could all be fed.
是因为埃及里面有一个约瑟。
And this was because Egypt had Joseph.
他知道怎么去管理他储藏这些粮食。
He knew how to manage all of the storage.
这都是神的恩典。
This was all the grace of God.
这也是神的安排。
This is the arrangement of God.
所以今天我们等候神的救恩。
So today we are waiting for God's salvation.
我们即使遇到患难困苦的时候。
Even when we are facing tribulations.
我们最后都能够看到神美好的旨意。
At the end, we can still see the beautiful will of God.
所以神与相信他的人一直同在。
And so God had.
神跟相信他的人一直都同在的。
And so we need to believe that God is always with him.
虽然患难，神还是在。
Even though there are tribulations, God is there.
神最后要让患难成为祝福。
And God will turn these tribulations into blessings.
那我们从雅各跟约瑟他们最后要离开世间所说的话，所留下的命令来看到一个重点。
And from Jacob and Joseph in their last words before they departed this world, we could see one emphasis.
真的有救恩的人是他们知道。他们要在神的产业上有份。
Those who truly have salvation are those who know that they have part in the inheritance.
虽然雅各，你看他在埃及享受真的是荣华富贵啊。
Even though Jacob was enjoying all of the great abundance,
他是那个宰相的父亲呢。
Because his son was the prime minister.
那约瑟虽然是宰相，但是他不是王啊。
Even though Joseph was the prime minister, he was not pharaoh.
那雅各他是一个牧羊人，他是一个聚居的人。
Jacob was just someone who was a shepherd.
他在埃及生活17年。
He lived in Egypt for 17 years.
他要死的时候
，When he was about to die,
他跟他儿子这样说。
He told his son.
我们看第四十九章。
Genesis 49.
第四十九章。
49.
第二十九节。
Verse 29.
他特别跟他的儿子交代。
He especially spoke to his son.
我将要归到我列祖那里去，你要将我葬在赫人以弗伦的田间的洞里，跟我祖父、我父在一起。四十九章的第二十九节。
49:29. Then he charged them and said to them, "I'm to be gathered to my people, bury me with my fathers in the cave that is in the field of Ephron the Hittite."
就是说，你不能够把我埋葬在埃及地。
Which means that you cannot bury me in Egypt.
你一定要把我带上去。
You must bring me up.
在那个地方是亚伯拉罕跟撒拉、以撒跟利百加，还有利亚的坟墓。
That was the place where Abraham and Rebecca and Isaac were buried.
你看，这个就是他列祖的坟墓了。
And this was the grave of their families.
雅各说他要葬在那里。
Jacob said he was going to be buried there.
三十三节，雅各吩咐众子一臂，就把脚收在床上，弃节而死，归到他列祖那里去了。
33. And when Jacob had finished commanding his sons, he drew his feet up into the bed and breathed his last, and was gathered to his people.
接下去我们就看到约瑟怎么样去安葬他的父亲。
And then we could see how Joseph had gone to bury his father.
真的是非常盛大的一个安葬礼。
And it was a very grand burial.
这是在圣经里面很少出现，就是唯一这一次这么隆重的这个埋葬。
And the Bible, it was rarely recorded about burials that were.
是为一个牧羊人所做的。
And this was done for a shepherd.
这个人不是什么掌权的人。
This was not someone who had much authority.
但是他却是一个紧紧抓住神的人。
But he is someone who held on to God.
他为什么要这样子
？Why did he do this?
因为他相信神的应许。
Because he believed in the promise of God.
他神跟他说：“你下去，我会在你带到迦南地来。”
God had told him that you will go down, but you will come back to Canaan.
那你的儿子会给你送终。
And your father and your son will bury you.
也就是说，雅各知道最后神一定要把他葬回到迦南美地来。
And so Jacob knew that God would let him be buried in Canaan.
这个就是雅各他当时候的信心。
This was what Jacob had encountered.
他看到的盼望就是神赐福的应许的地方。
And this was the hope that he had seen where God had.
埃及虽然好，但是它不是他永远居住的地方。
Egypt was good, but it was not where he would dwell forever.
他是在迦南地出生的。
He was born in Canaan.
他要 要回到神所应许的这个迦南地来。
And he needed to return the place where God promised him.
雅各的这样的一个要葬在迦南地的想法。
For Jacob to be buried here in Canaan.
最后也是约瑟他相同的想法。
Was ultimately also what Joseph decided.
所以约瑟，你看他做一个埃及的宰相。
And so Joseph was the prime minister of
Egypt. 当他要死的时候。
When he was about to die,
他跟他的兄弟们说，
he told his brothers,
看50:24,
in chapter 50:24,
约瑟对他弟兄们说，我要死了，但神必定看顾你们，领你们从这个地上去，到他启示所应许给亚伯拉罕、以撒、雅各之地。
24, and Joseph said to his brethren, I am dying, but God will surely visit you and bring you out of this land to a land of which he swore to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob.
25节，约瑟就叫以色列的子孙起誓说，神必定看顾你们，你们要把我的骸骨从这地从这里搬上去。
25, then Joseph took an oath from the children of Israel, saying, God will surely visit you, and you shall carry up my bones from here.
26节，约瑟死了，正110岁，人用香料将他熏了，把他收敛在棺材里，停在埃及。
26, so Joseph died being 110 years old, and they embalmed him, and he was put in a coffin in Egypt.
这是约瑟他因着相信神他的应许，他最后一具棺材停在埃及。
And because Joseph believed, and then he was put into a coffin in Egypt.
这一停了400多年。
And it had stayed there for 400 years.
一直到神的时间来到。
Until the time of God came.
神的选民才把约瑟的这个棺木把它从埃及抬上去。
Then God's chosen people had brought this coffin of Joseph.
要抬去葬在迦南地。
And brought it back to the land of Canaan.
因为当时候。约瑟他并没有吩咐说，你现在就要把我抬到去埋葬在迦南地啊。
At the time, Joseph did not say that you must immediately bury me in Canaan.
是因为他这个棺木要让所有的后代子孙都看得到。
It was because then the descendants could all see.
就算他是掌权的，在埃及权力掌权的这个宰相。
Even though he was the prime minister in Egypt.
当时候真的是全所有的埃及都是听约瑟的话。
At the time, the entire Egypt had to listen to him.
但是约瑟他并没有把他的目标，他最后的归宿放在埃及地。
But Joseph did not put his ultimate goal in Egypt.
他要让所有的他的后代子孙都明白，他的归宿是在天上，是在神所应许的迦南地。
He wanted his descendants to understand that he wanted to belong in Canaan.
也就是说，他对神的他的应许的信心。
And so he had this faith in God's promise.
我们现在看希伯来书第十一章。
Let's look at Hebrews 11.
希伯来书第十一章。
Hebrews 11.
第十一章，请看第21节。
Hebrews 11 verse 21.
希伯来书11:21。
Hebrews 11 verse 21.
雅各因着信，临死的时候给约瑟两个儿子各自祝福，伏着上头敬拜神。
Verse 21, by faith Jacob, when he was dying, blessed each of his sons of Joseph and worshiped, leaning on the top of his staff.
22节，约瑟因着信，临终的时候提到以色列族将来要出埃及，并为自己的骸骨留下遗命。
22, by faith Joseph, when he was dying, made mention of the departure of the children of Israel and gave instructions concerning his bones.
因为这个就是约瑟他的信心。
And this was the faith of Joseph.
也是他的盼望。
And his hope.
他知道他永远的归宿是在神的应许地。
He knew that where he belonged was actually in the land that God promised.
今天我们等候神的救恩。
Today we are waiting for God's salvation.
就是我们知道我们的归宿在哪里。
Because we know where we belong.
我们在地上事实上是寄居的。
We are just sojourners here.
我们是暂时活在这个世界，我们不是属这个世界的。
We are living here temporarily, but we do not belong to this world.
我们有信心，一定可以领受。
If we have faith, then we will accept this.
就是神所应许的那天国永远的产业。
That God has promised this eternal inheritance in heaven.
约瑟，你看他这个棺木一直停在埃及。
And for Joseph, for a very long time, his coffin
was in Egypt. 直到神的时候来到。
Until God's time came.
他真的，神的应许就实现了。
And then God's promise came true.
那所以我们今天看雅各的这个一生。
And so today, when we look at Jacob's life,
看约瑟的一生
and Joseph's life,
我们就看到我们的盼望在哪里。
We can see where our hope is.
我们等候神的救恩的，绝对不羞愧。
If we are waiting for God's salvation, then we would not be disappointed.
因为我们都能够明白我们所得到的拣选的恩典是何等宝贵。
May we all be able to understand how precious it is to be chosen.
让我们有属灵的眼光去看到神的安排是何等的奇妙。
That we have the spiritual sight to see how wonderful His arrangement is.
让我们可以明白我们神给我们的盼望是何等的真实，是 可以拥有的。
And we can understand that as hope is real and we can have it.
我们可以明白我们的神一生引导我们。
We can understand that our God is guiding us throughout our life.
要把永远的服事给我们。
And will give us eternal blessings.
一起来唱诗。
Sing hymn.
442首。
442.
我们一起来祷告。
We're going to pray together.
我们祷告的时候，我们特别为我们下午的福音茶会祷告。
During our prayer, we'll especially pray for our gospel tea fellowship in the afternoon.
祈求主耶稣基督，我们为我们打开福音的门。
And ask Lord Jesus to open the door of our gospel.
更多人能够来领受主耶稣的救恩。
That more people may come to receive the salvation of the Lord.
那么祈求主加添我们信心。
And we can also ask the Lord to strengthen our faith.
那么都能够明白神在我们身上所存的都是赐平安的。
How we can understand that all that we have and, is all given to us by God.
神的意念都是好的。
And what God has meant is good.
等候他人必不羞愧。
And those who wait on him will not be disappointed.
一起同心祷告。
Let's pray together.
奉耶稣圣名祷告。In the name of Jesus, we pray. Hallelujah.